Welcome to this next class of Dynamics of Charged Particles. In this class, we'll be looking at the problems relating motion of charged particle in electric field and motion of charged particle in magnetic field. Now, in these problems, I'll be trying to solve as much problems as possible. So I'll be not doing the calculations. I'll be writing the answers directly. So you can check the answers by doing the calculations later. Okay, let us look at the first problem. In the first problem, they have given us that what must be the initial velocity of an electron which can strike a conductor at -1200 volts potential. So, they are asking us what is the initial velocity. What is the initial velocity? And they have given us that it is of electron. So, we know the charge of electron is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulombs. And we will be requiring the mass of electron also, that is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg, and they have given us the potential, which is -1200 volts. Okay, this is what is given. Now let us try to understand the problem. They are basically talking about electric field. So the electric field, as we know, is between two plates, and one of this plate is having positive charge and one of this plate, as we know, will be having a negative charge. Now they have given us the potential difference between these plates, that is 1200 volts, that is the energy between the plates. Now they are asking us with what velocity we should release an electron. If I release an electron so that it strikes the negatively charged conductor. Now negatively charged conductor is at the lower end, and so I must release the electron at somewhere at the top. And now naturally what is going to happen? The electron is going to get attracted towards the positive plane. But if we give it sufficient initial velocity, it can move towards this plate. So they are asking us how much velocity initially we should give so that it moves through this distance and strikes this plate here, that is the negatively charged plate. So for this we should find out its electric field all between these plates. Okay, now let us look at how to solve this problem. Now try to remember that whenever they have given us potential, this potential is also equal to work done. We know the relation between work done and potential is work divided by the charge is equal to potential. So work will be equal to V into Q. Work will be always equal to V into Q. And this work we know is also equal to 1/2 mv², that is the kinetic energy. Work is equal to the kinetic energy, difference in kinetic energy or difference in the potential energy, it is equal to both. So we can take equation for potential or kinetic energy. So this 1/2 mv², that means will be equal to V, which is potential, into Q. Now this will help us to find out the initial velocity. Now V square will be equal to 2VQ divided by M. So V, that is the initial velocity, will be equal to square root of 2V, that is the potential, divided by M. Now we know potential they have given us 2 into 1200. Charge of electron we know is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 and this is divided by mass, that is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg. Now we can multiply this and try to find out the answer. Now what we'll be doing is we'll be multiplying this, we'll be trying to adjust the power first, and let us see by using the calculator. So what we have is 9.1, we have 1.6 into 1200 into divided by, this is divided by 9.1, so 210.98 we will get. Okay, again there is, it is multiplied by 2 also, so let us multiply that by 2. This answer should be multiplied by 2, so we'll get 421.97 into 10 raised to minus 19 and plus 31. This power is taken into the numerator, so we will get square root of this. First we'll try to bring the power outside this bracket, 97 into 10 raised to, now minus 19 plus 31 means we'll get plus 12. So we'll get 10 raised to 6 outside the bracket and it will be square root of 421.97. So let us look at the square root. Square root of 421.97 will be 20.54. So the velocity will be 20.54 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. This much initial velocity we must give to the electron, so that what will happen is it will be able to strike the other plate. So this was the first question. Now let us look at the second question. Okay, this is the second question. Now let us read the question. The electric field between the plates of a cathode ray oscilloscope is 1.2 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per coulomb. So this is the field between the plates. What deflection, they are asking us deflection, will an electron, the particle, the charged particle is electron, experience if it enters at right angle, the angle is important, they are telling us that it is entering at right angle, that means 90 degree, to the field with a kinetic energy, it is having some kinetic energy, and kinetic energy is given in electron volts, 2000 electron volts. The plates are 1.5 centimeter long. The length of the plates is also given. So first let us look at the diagram of this problem. So we have two plates. One will be positively charged and one will be negatively charged. Now they are given, the plates are 1.5 centimeters long, that means the length of these plates will be 1.5 centimeter. Again what they have given, the electric field that is between these plates is 1.2 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per coulomb. This is the field. Now this electron that is going to enter, it is going to enter in perpendicular direction, that means in this direction. The electric field is in this direction and the electron is going to enter perpendicular. Now we have seen what happens to such type of electrons. It will get deflected. It will get deflected, that means it will follow a parabolical path. And what they are asking is, how much is this deflection? this deflection is how much? Since this deflection is towards y axis, the deflection is y. That deflection that they are asking. Now we have derived an equation for this, if you remember. Y is equal to 1/2 a t square. This equation you remember. Initial velocity along y axis, they are asking us about the y axis. So initial velocity along y axis will be 0. So ut plus 1/2 a t square will basically become 1/2 a t square. And we know that a is eq by m, and t we can find from the horizontal component of the velocity. The horizontal component, the particle is entering perpendicular, that means it has this horizontal component which is vx, and the force is in perpendicular direction. This is the direction of the force. So this horizontal component will not change, and this horizontal component vx will be equal to distance. Now it is going to travel which distance? Horizontal distance. Horizontal distance is L. We are talking about inside the film, divided by T. So we can write T is equal to L divided by Vx. So T will be L divided by Vx. We have already derived equation for this. If we substitute this, Y will be equal to 1/2 A, that means EQ by M T square, that means L square divided by Vx square. Now what are the quantities that we know? We know what is L. Length of the plate is given, that is 1.5 centimeters. Electric field is also given, that is 1.2 into 10 raised to 4 Newton per coulomb. They have given us electron, that means charge is given, mass is given. And we will have to find out what is this V. This Vx, or the velocity, initial velocity is not given. To find the initial velocity, they have given us the kinetic energy of electron. So we can find the initial velocity. So kinetic energy, as we know, is 1/2 m V square. This V is Vx. Is equal to 2000 electron volts. Electron volts. Now, energy given in electron volts can be converted into joules by multiplying by 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. That is the charge of coulomb. And we can convert the joules into electron volts by doing the reverse process. That is by dividing by 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. That is the charge of electrons. So electron volts, we can convert this by multiplying with 1.6. So this will be 2000 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Electron volts should be converted into joules. Now let us keep this as it is, because see, in y equation also there is mv square. So let us see if we can directly substitute this value. And this mv square, if we bring this 2 on the other side, if we bring this 2 on the other side, mvx square will be 2 into 2000. That means we will get 4000 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Okay, we will not try to find out what is v. Because in both equation of y also mv square is there. Let us directly substitute this value. So mv square we have 4000 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Now we can find out what is y, which is equal to 1/2 into e. Let us see what is e. E is 1.2 into 10 raised to 4. 1.2 into 10 raised to 4 e. Then what we have is q. Q is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 into l. L square we have, that means 1.5 centimeters, that means 10 raised to minus 2 bracket square, the whole is divided by mv square. Now mv square, we have found out the value. It is 4000 into 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 90. Now see, many things will cancel. This 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 and 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 will directly cancel. Now if we calculate this, that will be y is equal to, we can cancel this, this will be 0.6. anything else we have, so we will have 0.6 into 1.5 into 1.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 square of 10 raised to minus 2 divided by 4000. So now we can calculate this by using a calculator. Let us calculate this. 0.6 into 1.5 into 1.5, and this is divided by, let us say, 4000. So we will get 0.003033375. This 10 raised to minus 4 and plus 4 will cancel, and we will get 0.000375. Now these three zeros are there, that means we can write 0.3375 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters. That means we can approximate this to 0.34 millimeter. That is the displacement the electron will suffer in a electric field. Okay, let us see the next problem. An electron beam is accelerated through a potential difference. Now potential difference is given, that means we can always find velocity. 1 half mv square is equal to this potential difference into charge, whatever the charge. Electron is there, that means 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. The electric field is applied at right angles to the path of the beam. So electric field is at 90 degrees. The distance between the plates is 1.25 centimeters. Now they are giving distance between the plates. So if these are the plates, the distance between them is 2.5 centimeters. And potential difference is 50 volts. Potential difference here is given is 50 volts. The edges of the plates are at distance 25 cm and 30 cm from the fluorescent screen. That means there is a screen somewhere and the distance of edges. Now distance of edges means one edge. This is one edge here and this is another edge here. One edge is at distance 25 cm and other edge is at distance 30 cm. So this is given to tell us two things. One is, what is the length of these plates? The length of the plates, as you know, will be 30 minus 25. This is 5 cm in length. And this will be our small l, that is the length of the plate. And this 25 cm will be our capital L. L, that is the distance from the plates to the screen. Now electron is going to enter at 90 degrees. That means the electron is going in this direction. The electric field is perpendicular from top to down. Electron will get deflected and it will hit the screen maybe somewhere here at this point. We have to find how much is this distance. This distance we have to find from here to here. As we know, we have found out an equation for this. We have derived an equation for this. That is, this y is the total displacement, y1 plus y2. y1 is the deflection in the field, whereas y2 is the deflection when the electron comes outside of this field. And we know this y1 plus y2 is 1 half eq by m into l divided by vx square. In bracket we have l by 2 plus capital L. L by 2 plus capital L. This is the equation for the total displacement. Now what are the things that we know? Small l is the length of the plates. That length of the plates is given. That is 5 cm. That means 5 into 10 raised to minus 2 meter. Capital L is the distance from the plates to the screen. That is also given. That is 25 into 10 raised to minus 2. Mass of the electron we know is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg. Charge of the electron we also know is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulombs. Electric field we don't know, we will have to find. And velocity Vx also we don't know, we will have to find. So this additional information is given to find out the electric field and the velocity. Now they have given us the potential. From potential we can easily find the velocity. Velocity we know is root of 2Vq, that is potential into charge, divided by m. So this will be root of 2 into potential. What is the potential that they have given? 50 volts. Potential is 50 volts. So 2 into 50 into we have 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 divided by mass of electron. That is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31. Now if you solve this, we will get the velocity of the electron. Velocity of the electron you will get is 1.87 into 10 raised to 7 meter per second. Okay, we will not try to do the calculation here. This is going to be a long problem. So we got the velocity. Electric field also we can easily find. Electric field, we know that potential V is equal to E into L. E into L. How do I get this equation? We know that work is equal to force into displacement, that is L. And force means electric field into charge into L. And if I send this Q on the other side, E into L, we will get W divided by Q. Now this W divided by Q is nothing but potential V, E into L. So we will get V is equal to E into L. From this we can easily find the electric field. Electric field will be equal to potential divided by this L. This L is the distance between the plates. L is the distance between the plates. So L, you don't confuse this L with the length of the plates. This is the distance between the plates. Let us write this as D. So V divided by D we have electric field. This will be 50 and distance between the plates I think so is given 2.5 centimeters. That means this divided by 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 2. We can easily find now the electric field. Electric field will be 50 divided by, let us take it 25 into 10 raised to minus 3. This will be 2. If we take 10 raised to minus 3 in the numerator, it will become plus 3. So it will be 2 into 10 raised to 3 newton per coulomb. So we have got the electric field that we wanted and we have got the velocity that we wanted to find out the total displacement. So let us put these values in the total displacement equation. So y which we know is 1/2 eq by m into l divided by vx square l by 2 plus capital L. Now all the quantities we know. So let us substitute this 1/2 into e. E is 2 into 10 raised to 3. Q we know is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. L, that is length of the plates. Length of the plates we know is 5 into 10 raised to minus 2. The whole is divided by mass, that means mass of electron is 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 into Vx square. V, let us check what is V, 1.87 into 10 raised to 7. So it is 1.87 into 10 raised to 7 bracket square. Again we have L, that is 5 into 10 raised to minus 2 divided by 2 plus capital L is 25 into 10 raised to minus 2. So if we solve this, what we will get is the total displacement of the particle. And the total displacement of the particle that you will get is 1.38 centimeter. This will be the total displacement of the particle. You can check this calculation. You can do this calculation and check whether we are getting this 1.38 centimeters or not. Now let us look at the next problem. A problem which involves magnetic field. In magnetic field, will be either asked to find out the radius or the pitch. Radius of that circle the particle is going to perform or the pitch of the helical path. So let us look at the question. An electron has a velocity of 10 raised to 4 meter per second. So initial velocity is given. Normal to the magnetic field. Normal means perpendicular to the magnetic field. So whenever it is normal, it is going to perform circles. So they will be asking us what is the radius. The magnetic field is 0.1 Weber per meter square. That is the unit of magnetic field. We have to find the radius and the frequency of the revolution. Now, they have given us what is the initial velocity, that is 10 raised to 4 meter per second. They have given us the magnetic field, that is 0.1 Weber per meter square. And they have asked us what is the radius and what is the frequency. This we can easily find. As you know, it is going to perform circles. So we have centripetal force. Centripetal force, as we know, will be mv square by capital R is equal to this magnetic force. Magnetic force is qv into b. When the angle sine theta is 90 degree. So we can easily find out what will be R. R will be mv divided by q into b. So m, I think so it is an electron, so it is the mass of electron m, that means 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kg into velocity is 10 raised to 4 meter per second divided by charge, that is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 into magnetic field, that is 0.1. So we will first try to adjust these powers, 9.1 divided by 1.6. These are the only numbers here, all others are powers. So let us write the powers here. 10 raised to minus 31 plus 4. And this in the denominator we have 10 raised to minus 20. 10 raised to minus 19 into 0.1. 0.1 is 10 raised to minus 1. So this will be 9.1. Okay, we'll solve this using calculator and finally write the answer. So we have 9.1 divided by 1.6, that is 5.68. This will get 5.68 into now we'll take this all 10 raised to minus 31 plus 4 plus 20, that is 24 minus 31. 24 minus 31 means we'll get minus 7. This will be 5.68 into 10 raised to minus 7 meters. This will be the radius of that circular path. So it will be a very small radius. Now they have also asked us the frequency of revolution. We know frequency is 1 by t, and t is 2 pi r divided by velocity. So this frequency will be 1 divided by 2 pi r. In numerator we will have velocity. So frequency, velocity we know is 10 raised to 4 and 2 into 3.14 into radius. Radius also we have found out, it is 5.68 into 10 raised to minus 7. So let us calculate this. In the denominator we have 2 into 3.14 and 5.68. So let us divide this first. So we have 1 divided by 2 into 3.14 into 5.68. So we'll get, we are getting 8.91. Let me check this. First we'll multiply and then we'll divide. So we'll get 35.67 if we multiply all of this. 35.67, so 1 divided by 35.67, we'll get 0.028 into 10 raised to 4 plus 7. That means it will become 10 raised to 11. So frequency we can write, we can bring this 28 outside, this 11 will be reduced by 2. That means 10 raised to 9. So the frequency will be 28 into 10 raised to 9 hertz. So that is a very high frequency. So these are some of the problems regarding the electric field and the magnetic field. Thank you.